Very good afternoon. I welcome you all to the day 13th of webinar series. Today's topic is Mathematical Tricks Using Vedic Maths by Archana M, Assistant Professor, Department of Science. Archana Ma'am, over to you.
Thank you, sir, for giving me an opportunity. So before today's my topic is Mathematic Tricks Using Vedic Maths. This session. So if you are interactive, it would be very nice. And before talking my why I selected this topic, Vedic mathematics or mathematical tricks using Vedic mathematics. So nowadays everyone we are used for the computers or mobiles or calculators for any kind of calculations, but when we go for competitive exams like banking exams or any competitive exams wherein we are not allowed with calces, so in such places if we know these mathematical tricks without calce, we can perform mathematical calculations within a short span of time and we can save more of the time. If we follow the usual way of calculations, it consumes more time, wherein if we use these tricks of Vedic mathematics, we can perform calculations within fraction of seconds, so that we can save our time and that time can be consumed for solving more number of questions, and hence this topic, it will be very optimal for everyone. So what is Vedic maths? Vedic maths is the name given to the ancient system, to the ancient system of mathematics, which was rediscovered from the Vedas between 1911 and 1918 by Sri Bharati Tirtha ji. According to his research, all of mathematics is based on 16 sutras. These 16 sutras describe the working procedure for solving problems. In the Vedic system, difficult problems or huge sums can often be solved immediately by the Vedic methods. Vedic mathematics manifest the coherent and unified structure of the mathematics, and the methods are complementary, direct, and easy. So why we need to learn this Vedic mathematics? What is the benefit of learning this Vedic mathematics? As I already mentioned, it saves our time. It helps a person to solve problems 10 to 15 times faster than the usual way of solving the solving any given problem. It also reduces burden. It provides one-line answers. It increases and improves concentration. It also enhances logical thinking process, and hence Vedic mathematics nowadays it is playing vital role. It also develops the interest and calculating capacity in mathematics by using the methods of Vedic maths. So as I said, Vedic maths was discovered by Sri Bharati Krishna Tirtha ji. He was born in 1884 and he was there till 1960. During 1911 and 1918, so this Vedic mathematics has been evolved. So Swamiji was Shankaracharya of Govardhanamat at Puri. He continues his study of the scriptures in Sringeri Math of Karnataka for 8 years. During this period, by meditating upon the Vedas in the woods, he formulates 16 simple sutras of Vedic mathematics. According to the Swamiji, these 16 sutras containing only 120 words are constructed out of mathematics present in appendix of Atharva Veda. He had written 16 volumes on Vedic mathematics, applying these sutras in various branches of mathematics. Along with religious and Vedantic discourses, Swamiji has popularized Vedic mathematics during his tour of the country and abroad. In the 50s, while in abroad, unfortunately, he has lost all his 16 volumes and is restarted writing the volumes, but due to is health conditions, you would able to complete only one volume of introduction. So this itself is a great treasure to the mankind now. So the 16 sutras given by the Swamiji is as follows: ekadikena purvena nikhilam navatas charamam dashatah urdvat tiryagbyam paravartya yojayet shunyam sam साम्य समुच्चये अनुरूप्ये शून्यमन्यत् संकलन व्यवकलनाभ्याम् पूर्ण अपूर्णाभ्याम् चलन कलनाभ्याम् यावदूनं व्यष्टि समष्टिः शेषान्यकेन चरमेण सोपान्त्य द्वयमन्यम् एकान्यूनेन पूर्वेण गुणित समुच्चयः गुणक समुच्चयः. दीज आर दि 16 मेन सूत्रास. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस वी हैव 13 सब सूत्रास आल्सो. दीज आर कॉल्ड एज सूत्रास और वर्ड फॉर्मुलास फॉर सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लम्स. सो नाउ वी शैल सी हाउ वी कैन सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम्स बेस्ड ऑन दीज सूत्रास. So firstly, ekadikena purvena. So ekadikena purvena means by one more than the previous one. So this sutra can be used for finding the squaring of the numbers ending in 5. How we can do it? Let us see it. So if you want to multiply 65 with 65, so here both the numbers it is ending with both the numbers it is ending with 5. If we want to multiply 65 with 65, we know the usual way of multiplication. We will multiply 5 with 5, so that is 25. 2 is carry over, then 5 into 6, that is 30. 30 plus 2, 32. Next we will multiply the same procedure, 5 into 5, 25, 6 into 5, 30. 3 carry over, 6 into 6, 36 plus 3, 39, and we will add up and we will get 4225. This is the usual way of calculation. So for calculating this, it consumes at least a minute or two. So by this one line formula of Vedic mathematics, the same thing, finding 65 into 65, how we can do it. So it is very simple. So 65 into 65. So here I'm writing with the help of mouse. Don't look at my handwriting, just concentrate on the concepts. So here one more than this 6. So 6 plus 1 it is 7. 6 into 7 that is 42. 6 into 7 that will be 42. Next 5 into 5 always it will be 25. So in single line we would be able to get the answer 65 into 65 it will be 4225. The same answer we had got from the traditional method also. So I'll repeat for this, we just need to consider. So 6 into 1 more than that. So 6 into 1 more than that, 6 plus 1 that is 7. 6 into 7, so 6 sevens are 42. So 5 into 5 always it will be 25. 6 into 1 more than that, and here 5 into 5 25, together we'll get the answer as 4225. So similarly we shall see few more examples. So if I want to find 15 square, wherein here also the number it is ending with 5. So we can find 15 into 15. So for finding 15 into 15, as I said here, it is 1 into the next number for 1, it is 2. 1 into 2, it is 2. And the 5 into 5, it will be 25. So finally the answer, it is 225. Similarly, if we want to find 35 square, here also the numbers it is ending with 5. So 35 into 35, what will be the answer? As I said, the 3 into the next number, 3 into 4, so that is 12, and 5 into 5, it will be 25. In one line, we can get the answer 1225. It will just take fraction of seconds for finding the product or finding the squares of any numbers ending with 5. So now, any one of you, you can try this product, finding the product 75 into 75, and you can reply in the chat box. It just takes seconds. 75 into 75. Yes. Yes, I'm getting the answers. 75 into 75. 7 into 8, it is 56. 5 into 5, it is 25. And similarly, 95 into 95, 9 into 10, it is 90, 5 into 5, 25. So answer, it is 9025. Similarly, 55 into 55, 5 into 6, 30, 5 into 5, 25. So 3025. So far we saw how to find the square of the numbers ending with 5. So similarly, now we shall see how to find the product numbers beginning with 5. So if I want to find 51 square, the number here, it is beginning with 5. So how can I do it? 51 into 51. So here the concept is, 5, we need to go for the L shape. So that is 5 into 5, always we need to find. 5 into 5, it is 25. 25 plus 1, L shape is. So like this, 5 into 5, 5 into 5, we will find, that is 25 plus 1. 25 plus 1, that is 26. And as usual, here 1 into 1, it will be 1. And while writing the 1, we need to denote it always in the two decimal places, and hence here I am denoting it by 0. So, and hence the product, it is given by 2601. Similarly, if I go for the next example, Fifty-eight square, same concept here. So 58 into 58, 5 into 5, it is 25. 25 plus 8, L shape, as I mentioned, it is L shape. 25 plus 8, so that is 33. So next, 8 into 8, it is 64. So final answer, it is given by 3364. So similarly, can you find a 52 square and 59 square, and you can reply in chat box. Anyone can reply? Yes. 52 square, it will be 25 plus 4, 29. 2 into 2, it is 04, 2904. Similarly, 59 square, it is given by 5 into 5, 25. 25 plus 9, it is 34. 9 square, it is 81. So 3481. 59 square, it will be 3481. 59 square. It will be 3481. So before proceeding further, here there is a simple activity. So consider any three-digit number. You can consider any three-digit number. You assume any three-digit number. Number starting from 100 to 999, you can assume any number. So multiply this number by 11. Multiply this number by 11. After that, you multiply it by 91, multiply it by 91. So after multiplying with 91, What is your answer? Your answer, it will be, your answer, it will be, anyone, you can unmute yourself and you can reply me. So your answer, it will be twice, the same number, it will be repeated twice. Suppose if you have assumed 222, suppose if you have assumed 222, your final answer will be 6 times 2, 222, 222, it will be repeated. Am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay, fine. We shall proceed further. So next sutra, it is Yavdunam Taudun Kritya Vargancha Yojaye. So this sutra means the this sutra means whatever the extent of its deficiency, lessen it still further to that very extent and also set up the square of that deficiency. So I'll explain you how we can solve the problems based on this sutra. If you want to find 98 square or any squares closer to 10 or 100 or 1000 or 10,000, like that, the numbers near to the base numbers squares we can find with the help of this formula. So here when we look at this 98, 98 is closer to 100, right? So, and 98 is just 2 less than 100. So 100 minus 2 will be 98, correct? So 100 minus 2 will be 98. So what we have to do is, what we have to do is lessen this 98 further more by 2, even more by 2. So 98 minus 2 will be how much? 96. 98 minus 2 will be how much? 96. And how much it is deficient? How much it is less? It is 2, right? So what will be 2 square? 2 square, it is 4. As I said, always we need to write it with the 2 decimal places. So and hence 4, it is written as 04. So within fraction of seconds, we can find any squares which is near to the base numbers. Any squares which is near to the base numbers. So suppose, one or three square. So this is closer to 100. This is closer to 100. And how much more than 100? It is 100 plus 3. 100 plus 3. So 3 is more than more, right? So what we have to do for this 103, we need to add 3 more extra. If we add 3 more extra, it will be 106. And 3 square, it will be 9. So we need to denote it with 2 decimal places. So it is denoted as 09. And 103 square, it is given by 10609. Similarly, 1009 square. So here it is closer to 1000 and it is closer to 1000 plus 9. So it is 9 more than 1000, and for this 1009, if we add 9, 9 plus 9, it will be 18. So it will be 1018. And since it is closer to 1000, in 1000 we are having 3 zeros, and hence though 9 square value is 81, we need to represent it with 3 decimal places, and hence here we need to write it as 081. And our final answer, it will be 1018081. So on the same lines, on the same basis, we can find few more squares. So suppose if I want to find 96 square, how we can do it? 96, it is less than 4 from 100, so reduce this 96 furthermore by 4, so it will be 92, and 4 square, it will be 16, and answer it is given by 9216. Similarly, if I find 104 square, so this is closer to 100 and it is 4 more than 100. So it will be 108, and 4 square, it is given by 16, and answer it is given by 10816. So similarly, 1003 whole square, 1003 whole square. So it will be from 1000, it is 3 more. So add 3 more for this. So 1006, and 6 square, it is 36. 3 square, it is 9. And in 1000, we are having 3 zeros. So this 9, it has to be denoted as 009. And the square of 1003 square, it is given by 1006009. So like this, the last example, if you want to find 99. Nine nine eight square, 99,908 square. If you want to find, how you can do it? So as we know, this is near to 99,998, means it is near to 1 lakh, and it is just 2 less than the 1 lakh. So what we have to do here, 99,000, reduce this entire sum by 2, so it becomes 99,996, and 2 lesser, right? So 2 square, it is 4, and that 4 we need to denote it as in 1 lakh, how many zeros we will be having? We will be having 5 zeros. So here it is given by 00004. So like this, if the numbers, if it is near to any of the base numbers, if it is closer to 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, 1 lakh, so nearby number squares, we can find it out very easily within fraction of seconds. So before going ahead, you have one more activity. So consider any number. You add the same number for it. You just double it. If you have assumed it as 5, 5 plus 5, it will be 10, like that. You just double it. After that, you add 5, then 12. Successively, then you subtract 3 from the above result, divide the entire number by 2, whatever the answer it is left out, you just divide it by 2, make it half. Any one of you can unmute yourself and you can reply me.
15, ma'am. So,
don't tell me the answer. So you just subtract the original number, whatever you have assumed. Subtract the original number, whatever you have assumed. So after subtracting the original number of whatever you have assumed, I'll tell you the left out number or remaining number, it is 7. Is it is right?
Correct, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, madam. Yes.
Okay, thank you. So we shall proceed further. So next, two digit multiplication by using the formula or sutra urdhva triyagyam. So this means vertically and crosswise. So this sutra is helpful for us for finding or multiplying any numbers. Any numbers, like it may be two numbers with two numbers or three numbers with three numbers, like that. So sir, here if I want to multiply 46 with 46 into 43, we know the usual way of multiplication. So for finding the usual way of multiplication, it takes 1 minute. I'll tell you how we can solve this by using this sutra 46 into 43. So before giving you the answer or solution, I'll explain this method. So first, basically we are having two digits, right? 46 and 43, these are the two digits. So I have taken four dots. Here we are having totally four numbers. So for representation of that, I have taken here four dots. So 4, 6, 4, 3, whatever the number it may be, if it is two digit with two digit multiplication, the rule says first you multiply these two like this. After that, that will be the first digit. For the second digit, so you multiply like this. You add, you multiply these two and these two, you sum up these two answers. That will be the middle digit. And for the last digit, you multiply like this. So that will be the last digit value. So this is the rule vertically and crosswise. So 4 into 4, what it will be? It will be 16. 4 into 4, it will be 16. I'll put a slash here. So next, 4 into 3, it is 12. Plus 6 into 4, it is 24. 24 plus 12, how much it will be? 36. Next, I'll put a slash here. Next, 6 into 3, if I multiply this 6 into 3, so it will be 18, right? So now we need to write like this. So 18, you write 8 as it is. So this one, it is carried over here. So 36 plus 1, it will be 37. So 37 means you write the unit place. So 7. Next 3, it is remaining. So this 3, it carries over here. So 16 plus 3, it is 19. So answer, it is given by 1978. Similarly, if I'll take one more example. Here 3 into 2, same method. So first we need to multiply like this vertically, then crosswise, then vertically. So 3 into 2, it will be 6. Put a slash. Next, 3 into 1, 3 plus 5 into 2, 10. 10 plus 3, it will be...
Archana ma'am. Sorry to interrupt. Can I go back to previous slide, please?
One minute. Yao method, sir?
Either method, back again. One minute.
Adral ulta hai da, sir.
Ulta
hai da. ನಾನೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ರೈಟ್ ಇಂದ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಗೆ ಬರಿತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ.
ಓಕೆ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಇಂದ ರೈಟ್
ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಇಂದ ರೈಟ್
ವಿಚ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಯಾವ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್?
ಎರಡು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸರ್, ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಇನ್ಕಂಫರ್ಟಬಲ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಹಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು, ಯಾವ ತರ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ.
ಓಕೆ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಗೋ ಅಹೆಡ್ ಗೋ ಅಹೆಡ್.
ಓಕೆ, 5 into 1 it is 5, so here units place it is 5, here 13 units place it is 3, so here 6 plus 1 it is 7, so answer it is 735. Similarly, this method it is applicable for multiplying any two digit with two digit numbers. So one more example, 16 into 27, so 1 into 2 it is 2. Next, 7 into 1 7 plus 6 into 2 12, 12 plus 7 it is 19. Next, 7 into 6 it is 42, so it is 2. If you carry 4 carries over, 19 plus 4 it is 23, so 2 carry over, so 2 plus 2 it is 4. Your answer is 432. So in this way we can multiply any two digit number with two digit numbers. Similarly, we can multiply three digit numbers by three digit number on the same concept. So for three digit number with the three digit number, first I'll give you the method. So as three digit number with three digit number, first we need to multiply like this, next two digits, next this with last, this with the last, and like this we need to sum up all these things. Next we need to multiply these two, next last. So totally 5 steps. For looking it appears like a huge concept, but it is not so. We can do it. I'll take one example of three digit number with the three digit number, 116 into 213. So here we are having three digit with three digit, so I'll start multiplying first. 1 into 2 it is 2, put a slash. Next, 1 into 1 plus 2 into 1, 1 plus 2 it is 3, put a slash. Next, 1 into 3 3 plus 6 into 2 12, 12 plus 3 it is 15, 1 into 1 it is 16, 15 plus 1 it is 16, put a slash. Next, 1 into 3 3 plus 6 into 1 6, 6 plus 3 it is 9, put a slash. Next, 6 into 3 it is 18. So now write the units place. So it is 8, 1 carries over, so 9 plus 1 it is 10. Write 0, 1 carry over. 16 plus 1 17, 1 carries over, so 3 plus 1 it is 4 and it is 2. Answer it is given by 24708. I'll take one more example. So here 2 into 3 it is 6, 3 into 2 it is 6, plus 3 into 2 it is 6, 6 plus 6 it will be 12. Next, 2 into 7 14, plus 5 into 3, 15, 14 plus 15, 29, 29 plus 6, it is 35. Put a slash. Next, 7 into 2, 14, 14 plus 15, it is 29. Put a slash. 7 into 5, it is 35. So 5 units plus 3 carries over. 29 plus 3, it is 32. 3 carries over. 35 plus 3, it is 38. 3 carries over. 12 plus 3, it is 15. 1 carries over. 6 plus 1, it is 7. Your answer, it is 75825. So say on the same concept, if you have the if you want to multiply 4-digit number with the 4-digit number, you can do it by the same method. The procedure is first this with this, next this with this, next it is 3-digit numbers, this with this and then with this, next 4-digit numbers. So first with last, like this, 2 intos, next it is the you leave the first column, the remaining 3 digits we need to do. Next it is like this, next it will be last. So with this procedure you can multiply the 4-digit number with 4-digit numbers also. So before moving on to the next concept, you have one more activity. Consider any 3-digit number. You can assume any 3-digit number. Repeat this 3-digit number to form a 6-digit, one in opposition. Like if you have assumed 1, 2, 3, repeat it 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So this forms 6-digit numbers. Divide the overall number by 7. Next, divide it by 11. Yes, Savita ma'am. Divide it by 13. So finally, you will arrive with the same number, whatever you have assumed. Right? Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. So next, moving ahead, it is next Sutra, it is Nikhilam Navatas Charamam Dashataha. So that means all from 9 and last from 10. So once again, this is we can do it. This is a method applied for doing the multiplications which are nearer to the basis, like 10, 100, 1000, etc. So the previous method, vertically crisscross method, whatever I explained so far, that is for any numbers, any two digit numbers with two digit numbers, or three digit with three digit, four digit with four digit. For that, universally we can apply that rule. Whereas this rule, it is for the numbers which is nearer to the base numbers. Like for example here, 96 into 98. So these two numbers are nearer to 100. Similarly, 102 into 104, this is also near to 100. So like this, any numbers which is close to base numbers, that is 10, 100 or 1000, we can employ this method. So I'll tell you how we can employ this method. Okay. 1 second. Yeah. Sorry for the interruptions. So here 97 into 94. Here these two numbers are closer to 100. We know usual way of multiplication. So usual way of multiplication, we will multiply 4 with 7, 28 to carry over 4 with 9, 36 plus 2, 38 and all. We will do like this. So this method, according to Vedic method or mathematical tricks. So here 97 is how much lesser than 100? It is 3 lesser than 100. So it is minus 3. Similarly, 94, how much lesser than 100? It is 6 lesser than 100, so it is minus 6. So next, what we have to do next after this, we need to write like this, it is minus 3. We should mention the sign whether it is lesser than the base number or greater than the base number. If it is lesser than the base number, we should denote it or indicate it by minus 3, negative sign. If it is greater, we should indicate it with positive sign. So here 97, it is lesser, so it is minus 3, minus 3. After that, so here you need to consider 97 minus 6 or 94 minus 3. 97 minus 6 means whatever you consider in these two, both it will give you the same answer. 97 minus 6 also it is 91, or 94 minus 3 also it gives you 91. So we got 91. Next, the product, minus into minus it is plus, 6 into 3, 18. So in one line you will get the answer. Product of 97 into 94, it is given by 9118. Similarly, we shall see few more examples based on the same concept. So 98. Into 98. So here 98, it is 2 less than 100. So 98, it is 2 less than 100. So it will be minus 2. Similarly, 98, this is also 2 less than 100. So it is minus 2. So 98 minus 2, it will be 96. And 2 into 2, it minus into minus, it is plus. 2 into 2, it will be 4. 4, we need to write it as 04. So 98 into 98, it will be 9604. So similarly, I'll take one more example of the same concept. 86 into 93. 86 into 93. So 86, it is minus 14, minus 4 less than 100. So next 93, it is minus 7 less than 100. So next 86 minus 7 or 93 minus 14. So 86 minus 7 or 93 minus 14 will give you 79. And 14 into 7, that gives you 98. So your answer, it is 7998. Similarly, the same concept can be applied for three-digit numbers or the numbers greater than 100 also. So here 103 into 105, both the numbers, it is greater than 100. So 103, 3 more than 100, 105, 5 more than 100. So 103 minus 5 or 105 minus 3, here 3 greater than So here 3 greater than 100, so sine is plus 3, here sine is plus 5, so 103 plus 5, before it was lesser and hence we subtracted, here it is greater and hence we need to add. 103 plus 5, it is 108, or 105 plus 3, it is 108, next 5 into 3, it is 15, so we will get the answer as 10815. I'll consider few more examples on the same. 101 into 112. So it is 101 112. So both the numbers, it is greater than 100 itself. It is 1 greater than 100. Here it is 12 greater than 100. So 101 plus 12, it is 113. And plus into plus, plus 12 into 1, 12. So answer, it is given by 11312. So the last example for the same method, we can apply this for four digit numbers or the numbers near to 1000 also. So 1005 into 1015. So 1005, 5 is more. 1015, it is 15 more, both it is plus. So 1005 plus 15, 1020, 5 into 5, it is 15 into 5, it is 75. But this is closer to 1000. In 1000, we are having 3 zeros. So 75, we need to denote it as 075. So your answer, it is 1020075. So you can employ the same. You can employ the same method even for one number if it is less than 100 or base number, and the other number you can another number. Another number, if it is more than 100, for that case also you can employ this. 103, it is greater than, so it is plus 3. 98, it is less than 100, so it is minus 2. 103 minus 2 or 98 plus 3. So both it gives you 101. So it should be 101. and 3 into 2 it is 6, so plus into minus it will be minus, right? So what we should do here, both the numbers it is closer to 100, and here since one is more and one is less, so I'll add two zeros basically. So I have done here 103 minus 2, so that is 101, and this base is 100. In 100 we will be having two zeros, so I have added here two zeros. Next here 3 into 2 it is 6, and the sign plus into minus it will be minus. So from this sum, from 10,100 we need to subtract 6. If we subtract 6 we will get 10,094, so that will be the answer. So before proceeding further, one more activity. So this table actually reveals any person's age. If you don't want to reveal your age, you can assume any number. Any one of you can unmute yourself and you can reply to me. Any one of you, please assume any number in this chat and you tell me. First you assume, any one of you first unmute yourself.
Yeah, Archana ma'am, tell me.
Ma'am, you assume any number. Have you assumed, ma'am?
Ma'am, just assumption, or you can guess my age. I don't have any problem.
Okay, you assume your age itself, but don't tell me.
Okay, ma'am.
You assumed, right, ma'am? Yeah. The number, whatever you have assumed, is it there in the first column?
Yeah, ma'am.
It is there in the first column, ma'am?
Yeah, ma'am.
Second column?
Second column. No, ma'am.
Third column?
Yeah, ma'am, it's there.
Fourth column?
Fourth column. No, ma'am.
Fifth column.
No, ma'am. It's in the last column.
It's in the last column.
Yeah, ma'am.
Mama, one second, can you repeat it, ma'am? It is in which column, like?
It's in first.
Ma'am,
I think that has gone.
That has gone.
Yeah, ma'am. In first column it is there. Column it is there. And in the last column it is there.
Okay. One second, ma'am. Thirty-seven, ma'am.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. The number you have assumed is 37.
Yeah, ma'am, I can mute now.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am, thank you.
Okay, ma'am, thank you, ma'am. So the next concept, it is tricks with 9. If you want to multiply.
Ma'am, you didn't tell me how you guessed my age exactly.
Mama, you want me to reveal it?
Yeah, ma'am.
Mama, in that table, it is there, no, ma'am? Hello?
Ma'am.
In that table, if the number, whatever we have assumed, if it is there in the first column, second, third, or whichever the columns it is there, the first row, if it is, you said you, it is there in the first, third, and fifth, right? The
yeah.
Values of the first row, if we add up, values of the first row, if we add up, that gives the number, ma'am.
Oh, okay, ma'am. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, ma'am. So next, it is tricks with nines. So suppose if you want to multiply. Four into nine. So what we can do here is it is very simple. Lesser this four by one. Four minus one, it is three. And how much I should add for this three to make the sum as nine? So if I add six for this three, the sum will be nine. So everyone knows four into nine, it is 36. But still, the trick is. Lesser this 4 by 1, any number by 1, so it will be 3. Add the remaining number to make it as 9. So suppose if I take one more number as 7 into 9, 1 less than 7, it is 6. Add how much I should add to make this sum as 9, so that is 3. So 7 into 9, that will be 63. Similarly, 37 into 99. Here, this side also we have two places. This side also we have two digits. And how we can perform? So, lessen this number 37 whole number by 1. If you lessen this 37 by 1, it will be 36. So, next. For the first digit 3, how much I should add to make it as 9? So that is 6. For the second digit, how much I should make add to make it as 9? So that is 3. In this way, it is 3663. So on the same lines, the last example, as the time is running, 53816 into 9999. Don't look at my handwriting, please. Kindly, I'm writing with mouse. Bear it. So, bear me. Reduce this entire number by one. So, it will be 53815. So, next. How much I should add for this 5 to make it as 9? So that is 4. For next digit, how much I should add? So that is 6. For next, for 8, I should add 1. For 1, I should add 8. So for 5, I should add 4. So product of this huge numbers, it is just given within fraction of seconds. So like this, we can find if we want to multiply with 9. So similarly, tricks with 11. So for that, first you write the first digit as it is. Next, 2 plus 3, how much? 5. Write the last digit as it is. So your answer, it is given by 253. Similarly, I'll take one more example. 234 into 11. So first digit, you write it as it is. 2 plus 3, sum, it is 5. 3 plus 4, sum, it is 7. So write the last digit as it is. So it is 2574. Suppose if I'm multiplying 2, 3, 1 into 111. So 111, here previous example it is with two ones, here it is with 111. So if that is the case, first you write the first digit as it is 2. Next you sum up the next two digits, 2 plus 3 it is 5. Next you sum up three digits, 2 plus 3 plus 1, so that will be 6. Next it is last 2, 3 plus 1, so that is 3 plus 1, that is 4. Next the last digit, it is 1. Handwriting, it is going very worse. So 25641, your answer, it will be 25641. The trick for three digit number, that is 111, is 111 is 1 1 2 3. Next decrease it by 3 2 1, like that. Six, nine, four into 111. So here we are having six digits. The concept is first one, next two. So we are having six digits, right? So 1 2, third digit, fourth digit, fifth digit, sixth digit. Next, decrease it by last 2 and then 1. So like this we need to do. So first digit, we write 3 as it is. Next, sum of the first 2 digits. So 8 plus 3, put a slash since it is very huge number. We will get 2 digit numbers and hence we need to put a slash. So 8 plus 3, it is 11. Next, sum of three digit numbers, 3 plus 8 plus 7. So it is 18. Put a slash. Next, so we have finished with these three digits. Go for, leave the first digit now. Go for the remaining three digits. 8 plus 7 plus 6. So 8 plus 7, 15. 15 plus 6, it is 21. So now you leave the second digit, go for these three digits. So 7 plus 6, 13 plus 9. 13 plus 9, it will be 22. So next you leave this 7 also. Now you go for last three digits. 6 plus 9, 15. 15 plus 4, it is 19. So next, last two digits, 9 plus 4, it is 13. Next, the last digit, it is 4. So now you write 4 as it is. So out of 13, you write 3. So 1 is carry over. 19 plus 1, 20. So 2 is carry over. 22 plus 2, 24. So this 2 is carry over. 21 plus 2, it is 23. 2 is carry over. 18 plus 2, it is 20. So 2 is carry over. 11 plus 2, it is 13. 1 is carry over. So 3 plus 1, so that is 4. The product, it is given by 4304034. If you want to find 11 square, so write 1. 1 plus 1, that is 2. The last digit, it is 1. 1, 2, 1. Similarly, if you want to find 111 square, so write 1. 1 plus 1, it is 2. 1 plus 1 plus, as I said, the same 1, 2, 3 concept. So 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 1, it is 3. Next, the last two digits, so it is 2. Remaining last digit, it is 1. Similarly, 111 square, it is easily we can say 4 ones we are having. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 1. So similarly, if you want to find 101 square, so 11 square, it is 121, we know. Between 1 and 1, here 10 is there. So here also you add 10. So 101 square, it will be 10201. So like this, you can do it. The last thing. If you want to find 13 into 22, so you can find the first digit or unit's place, multiply 3 into 2, it is 6, and multiply the tens place with the tens place, 2 into 1, that is 2. So for the middle place, what we can do here is 3 into 2, 6, plus 1 into 2, 8. 6 plus 2, it is 8. So your answer, it is 286. This technique can be employed for multiplying any two-digit numbers with two-digit numbers. So, did you like this session?
Yes, ma'am. We have learned many tricks today.
Okay, thank you, sir. Any doubts, sir?
We'll give 1 or 2 minutes to the faculties. If they have doubts, they will ask.
Okay, so then, sir.
Okay. Faculties, don't leave the session. We have two announcements. Please be online. Once the session is over, then we'll